हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। सो आई एम गोइंग टू प्रिपेयर माय पार्ट टू वीडियो फॉर प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सीट टेक्नोलॉजी। आई विश यू ऑलरेडी वॉच्ड माय फर्स्ट पार्ट, सो कंटिन्यू टू दैट पार्ट। आई विल डिस्कस डिफरेंट फेजेस ऑफ सीड सर्टिफिकेशन, जनरेशन सिस्टम ऑफ सीड्स एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट कंसेप्ट्स व्हिच वी आर यूजिंग ड्यूरिंग हाइब्रिड सीड प्रोडक्शन। सो दैट पार्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन दिस वीडियो। So watch this video till end, so you will get all information. If you not subscribe my channel, subscribe my channel, like video. So we will start today's topic, seed certification phases. For seed certification, we have different 6 phases. First phase is application for seed certification, then verification of seed source. Third is field inspection. Fourth, post harvest supervision of seeds crop. Fifth, seed sampling and testing, and last, labeling, tagging, sealing and grant of certificate. So first phase, application for seed certification. So in that, the person who is producing the seeds, he need to apply for the seed certification, and application will be done on the name of concerned assistant director of seed certification, and he need to pay specific fees for each crop in each season. Then during the application, he need to submit the sowing report, and in that sowing report he will mention the which crop he is going to grow, then what is the area. So all information, what isolation distance he have maintained, so all isolation, all information he need to mention there in that format. Then second phase is the verification of seed source, and you know this second phase actually we are doing during third phase, because verification of the seed source will be done by seed certification officers. So we can say that is the field inspector, and that will be done during first inspection of a seed farm. So during that verification, seed certification officer will see that the whatever seed you have used for sowing, that is from appropriate source or not. Then field inspection is the third phase, and what is the main objective of field inspection is to verify the factor which causes the irreversible damage to the genetic purity or seed health. And the number of field inspection are vary from crop to crop, because suppose if there is a mode of pollination is changed, like as if crop is self pollinated, number of field inspection are less as compared to cross pollinated crop. And then purpose of the seed production, if you are doing the seed production for varieties, the number of field inspection are less and as compared to hybrids, because for hybrids we need to do minimum 3 to 4 number of field inspection, and that because we need to take much care. So for number of field inspection, generally first field inspection need to done before flowering, and that is the most important field inspection, because during that time you are completing the second phase, that is the verification of seed source also. And you will see what is the isolation distance they have maintained, what is the area they have grown, and that area should be mentioned during application. So same area is should be there. Then is there any op types are there or not. So all these information need to taken during first field inspection, and then he will guide to the seed producer to how to do the rogging, how to identify the op types, okay, and how to remove the pollen seeders. So all the information which is needed to done on the field will be provided by that seed certification officer. Second field inspection will be done at the time of flowering, and during flowering he will confirm that whatever information he have given during first inspection that correctly followed by seed producer or not. He will check how many pollen shedders are there, how many pollinated plants are there, is there any disease, pest or weeds. So like that all information will be checked. Then third field inspection will be done after flowering, and last field inspection will be done before the harvesting. So during these four field inspection, how many field counts need to taken? When he will do the field inspection, that time he need to do the field counts. So the purpose of field inspection is to find out the field standard of various factor in the producing seed farm, but it is impossible to examine all the plants in the seed farm because in lakhs plants are there. So field inspector will be examine one specific number of plants in a random counting, and the random counting is called as number of field counts. So the random counting is depend on area. So if area is up to 5 acre, the number of counts will be 5. So maybe it will be 1 acre, 2 acre, 3 acre, 5 acre, then 5 counts need to done. But after increase of the area from 5 acre, then for every 5 acre increasing area, he will increase one more count. Suppose he have 6 to 10 acre production inspection, then he will use 6 count. 11 to 15, he will use 7 counts. 16 to 20 acre area, he will use he will do 8 counts. So like that he need to increase one count after increase of the area by 5 acre. Then after doing all field inspection, he will prepare the liable for rejection report if that field is not fulfilling any field standard factor, maybe isolation distance, maybe seed source, maybe pollen shedders are there, maybe disease is not controlled, so whatever. So he will prepare the, if that plot is rejected, then he will prepare liable for rejection report, and within a 24 hours he will send that report to the deputy director of seed certification. Then after rejection of report, that seed producer can apply for re-inspection within the 7 days from the date of in rejection of the your field inspection. Then next phase is post-harvest supervision of seed crops. So the post-harvest inspection of seed crop covers the observations carried out at the threshing, then transport, then seed processing like cleaning, drying, grading, seed treatment, bagging, and post-harvest processing storage of the seed lot. So this is about the fourth phase of the seed certification. Then fifth phase of seed certification is sampling and testing. So that seed inspector need to take samples, and they need to follow the ISTA procedure for sampling as well as testing. So the last phase is labeling, tagging, sealing and grant of the certification. So after doing the all seed and field certification and then seed testing analysis, that seed certification officer will get the tag from assistant director of seed certification, and he will get the label. So for certified seed he will get blue color tag, and for foundation seed he will get white color tags, and that tag will be provided to the seed producer, and that validity period for that tag should be for 9 months, and tagging should be done within 60 days of testing month. So that is the important points need to remember. Next topic we will discuss, that is the classes of seeds, also we are calling as a generation system of the seeds. And in India we are following 3-generation system, that is the breeder seed, foundation seed and certified seed. So in India we are not following nucleus seed and registered seed generation. From the nucleus seed producing breeder seed, from breeder seed production of foundation seed, and in foundation seed there are two generations, foundation seed 1 and foundation seed stage 2. Foundation seed 1 is producing from breeder seed and foundation seed 2 is producing from foundation 1. In certified seed also there are two certified seed stage 1 and stage 2. Generally certified seed stage 1 we are producing from the foundation seed stage 1, and certified seed stage 2 is producing from certified seed stage 1. About the seed tag color, there is no seed tag color for nucleus seed, but for breeder seed we are using golden yellow tag color, for foundation seed white color tag color, and for registered seed we are using purple tag color, and for certified seed we are using blue tag color. And among these all generation system, certified seed is commonly using for seed production purpose by farmers. So the most pure seed is nucleus seed, then breeder seed, then foundation seed, and then certified seed. These are the tags which we are using for seeds. First tag is for breeder seed, color is golden yellow. Second tag is foundation seed, color is white. And third tag is certified seed, color is azure blue. And last tag is truthful label seed, that is color is opal green color. And you know, generally in private sector, the truthful label seed is using or producing because they don't require seed certification. So the organization or the private company who is producing truthful label seed, they are responsible by their own for any mishappening with seed. Already we have discussed hybrid seed production of different crops in part 1. So just I want to discuss few concepts which are always important for exam point of view. So first is a synchronization, or we can say synchronous flowering. Synchronous flowering means when both male and female maturing at a same time is called as synchronous flowering, and that is important for hybrid seed production because we are making the cross between A and R line, so both should be mature at a same time. Then live marker is the another concept generally we are using. Live marker means to identify the R line, we are growing some distinct plants or crop in front of that R line. Suppose you are growing the live marker in front of maize, then crop like marigold, crop like mustard, sunflower you can grow. That will be very distinct and you can easily detect the where is R line. Then staggered planting is another concept generally using during hybrid seed production. Staggered planting means you are doing the planting of male and female at a different dates for synchronous flowering. So that is called as staggered planting. And we are using pollen shader concept, voluntary plants already we have discussed in last part. Then jerking concept we are using in bajra generally. So jerking means the first tiller we are removing, and that first tiller is removing for uniform flowering in lateral tillers. So they will come at a time and all will flower at a time. So that we are doing for uniform flowering in that line. About the release of the hybrids, maize is the first crop in India in which we have released the first hybrid. So in 1957, through All India Co-ordinated Research Project, we have released the first four hybrids of the maize, and name is Ganga 1, Ganga 101, Ranjit and Deccan. After maize, sorghum is the second crop in which we have released the hybrid. So CSH1 hybrid we have released in 1964. And the male style line which we used up is Kafir 60A. Then third crop is bajra. So we have released a hybrid in 1965. The name of hybrid is HB1. Punjab Agricultural University released that hybrid by using TIPTA 23A male style line.
Then in 1970 we have released the H4 hybrid of cotton first time in the world. So C.T. Patel is the scientist, and we are calling C.T. Patel is the father of hybrid cotton of the world. Then remember ICPH8 is the first hybrid of PGNP released by Chris Hatt in 1991 by using genetic male sterility system. This is about the second part of our video. If you not subscribe my channel, you subscribe my channel, like the video and press the bell icon. Thank you.